Okay, Revenants, welcome back. Good to see you again here in Vayne. This is episode whatever something, 100 something of the Road to 100. It's getting pretty high on the episode count, but we're going to get through it. So today we're going to be finishing up some optional missions after the Crown of Sand, and we are going to be running the Hades sneaky backstab stun build that I've harebrained up here. So we got this fella first.
Gonna be the site of a new shelter. All the folks with me will have a home. We're saying goodbye to the vagabond life. Well, me and my friends couldn't have done it on our own. We wouldn't have made it anywhere without you.
That's right.
We all really appreciate what you've done. Thank you.
No problem. So he's
just simply a
thank you here. Okay, so he's good now, so he will show up in a different place now that he is done here in the butterfly nest. So this is how you get the Rocky Ruins quest line to get this depths map, is by finishing up this fella. And as he's continually followed us kind of through Vayne here, through the past, through the present, and here into the future, he's a fun little kind of comedic relief here in between. And as you see here in the crossroads, Shang does not have anything for us. We are only here to use him to purchase things at this time. So we've completed him, we've completed everybody else, so it's time to head on into the Crypt Spire. And this should be kind of interesting to utilize Hades as a backstab build. And I want to try for the Bladebearer and Cannoneer fight, I want to try something different for that. I've alluded to it in the past, I've gotten pretty close, but we'll see if we can actually do what I want to do. Something that you know, I'd like to talk about is subscribers on the channel. As you know, we're up to like 74 now or something like this, and that's kind of nice, but it doesn't exactly portray what's happening here on the channel. But what it is nice for, I'll tell you this, it's very nice to know that that new people, as they continue to find the channel and watch through the different playlists and through the different things, that it's nice to see that they enjoy it enough to you know, throw a free subscription this way. However, the other interesting thing is that most of the views, so this is where I kind of learn about who the audience is. Most of the views are coming from folks who are already subscribed, and they watch a lot of minutes. However, most of the watch minutes come from, but most of the actual views come from new people just passing through. So just welcome to all the people who are passing through, and also for those folks that are sticking around and actually putting time in to actually watch through these crazy bizarre bonanza things that were going on here, and all the suggestions that you guys are giving, and watching the pain of everything. You know, it's a really big thank you to all of you, as you are kind of the lifeblood of what's going on here. So as we continue on, we'll be running the Road to 100 here, and for those that may not understand what that is, we're going for 100 stars of difficulty, and we are currently at 29. This will be our 30th star once we complete this run, and which is why we are going to be completing 30 stars this run, so we do a 100% run. Okay, let's go ahead and get him stunned. And there we go. Oops. Now, as we have opportunism equipped here on our passive, I was hoping there that we would go for we would go and get a backstab while he was stunned, so we could get that extra 20% damage increase, but it doesn't look like that's going to be the case. So we're going to be needing to do lightning damage versus most of the enemies in here. However, we will keep the ice going, because as you'll see, the amount of damage that we can put out, 15,000 on these fellas, it's a little bit of a ridiculous amount of damage, so we'll just go ahead and keep it for now, especially when we have when we're paired up with Louis. Okay, let's go for a backstab on this guy, and we'll see if this even kills. Not quite. There we go, and we'll just take him down. So as you can see, if we are able to get a backstab, we are completely super overpowered for this point in the game. But that's completely okay, and I don't have any problems with that. Okay, so let's go for Night Stalker and Night Fog Veil. Now this should put these two fellas down very easily and quickly. There we go, and then a couple of slashes. And because we have Louis' overdrive and our overdrive as well, we are able to completely ruin these fellas. Okay, let's go for a drain. I mean, why not? There we go. See, now that was 6319, and our backstab does about almost 16,000. So you can see the difference damage that is available to us here. Drain attacks, I believe, are like 1.9 times drain attack, like charge drains, and then backstabs are I think like a 3 times or a 4 times or something like that. So it's good to have an idea of what your damage is coming from. Okay, so since Night Stalker is still available, we can go for Night Fog Veil and Gift Extension and make things last a little bit longer here. So we can go for this fella first, and then we gotta hot foot it over to the what is that guy? The Dark Hunter guy. Good. And since Night Stalker is still active, we definitely we're definitely able to sneak up on all these guys easily. There we go. There we go, and we'll just slash him down easily and quickly. Okay, good. So now, since we are going to be doing a 100% here, instead of going to the right where we should be going, we are going to go to the left and go ahead and take care of these fellas. Okay, and we will go for overdrive and go for max damage if we can. Now, since there's two of these guys, it's good to eliminate them quickly, as they will gang up on you and ruin your day. Okay, let's go for stun. There we go. Now, these fellas with the shields are very rare indeed, and this is one of the places where you encounter one of them. Okay, so the reason you would want to come over here is a regen extension factor, and this is a place, you know, since there's only 10 in the game, this is one of them, and it's good to pick this up, as, you know, you usually don't have a lot of them, so it's good to have them. Alright, so let's go ahead and head in here and cloak up, so we can go for a backstab on Big Chunky Boy here, and get to the monkeys hopefully as soon as possible. There we go. Okay, and monkey. Good. And he needs to go down. Very good. Now we don't have a whole lot of time here, as Night Fog Veil is about to run out. Oops. There we go. And this monkey, he needs to go down. There we go. Okay. So not too bad with the monkeys there. Let's go ahead and open the door, as we will hopefully not be coming back this way again. But you never know, once we do the invasion, we'll have to see how that goes, as we will be visible the whole time, and since we're relying on backstabs, it's going to be problematic. Now here is a blood coat, and we pick up warrior, so this is a pretty good blood code, to say the least, but it does suffer from what we've discovered in the past. It suffers from stamina, a lack of stamina, so we don't put a whole lot of time into Okay, we don't put a whole lot of time into Warrior, which is unfortunate because it's a pretty good blood code otherwise. Okay, so as we head in here, we have this fella, and it's important to continue to backstab him and put him down quickly, as he is extremely problematic here on the stairs. And what do we get? We get the Misty Ruins. Now, we probably won't be doing the Misty Ruins this run, this episode. We'll probably pick that up and in the next episode, as that is basically running the Crown of Sand all over again. And since we've seen that already, we will probably save that for another optional missions cleanup episode. So, whatever we used in the Crown of Sand would be applicable in the Misty Ruins as well as the Rocky Ruins. Okay, so here we go. We're going to be running this invasion, but let's go ahead and open this door first with this beautiful lighting in here. Oh my, I just love the lighting in here, as that color of gold is exceptional. Yep, it sure is. Oh my, it's wonderful. Okay, so here we go. We will go for Somatic Zeal and Stun. There we go. And let's start the invasion. Let's get some backstabs here. And hopefully we won't be getting hit. Oh, we did get hit because of the timing. Okay. And let's go for another backstab. This will be pretty problematic in here, I would imagine. Let's go for Gift Extension. Okay, so they're coming down the hallway. That is not good. There we go. And let's go directly for the big boy. Oh. Okay. And let's get him stabbed here so we can go ahead and hopefully get him stunned, maybe. Oh, great. We'll go for another backstab. And we'll go for little boy here. There we go. Now they're spawning out there, so we can head on out here and go for this big boy. Before he gets any kind of idea. There we go. And we got the backstab just in time as the little guy was coming around. Okay. And we'll go for another backstab, and we'll go for this guy, and then we will head back into the arena there. There we go. Now they're going to be coming from down the steps here, I believe. Oh, or just right here. Okay. I did not know they spawned directly on top of us. Okay, let's go for a backstab on this guy. And we will go for a stun. And... oh boy. Thank you, Louis. That was risky. Okay, don't die again, Louis, as I cannot heal you. Okay, he's going for me. Let's go for a launch. Okay. And the hunter should be coming here soon. Here he comes. Okay, let's see if we can go invisible. I doubt it, as this is an invasion. Yep, he's gonna shoot us. Oh, he's gonna shoot Louis. He's gonna shoot us now. Yep, there we go. Okay, and let's go for a backstab to stun him, basically, even though we're gonna get stunned on him. There we go. Okay. So, not too horrible. Oh, we got a Black Greatsword. Even better. Okay. Oh, and a regen inducer. Too bad. Let's go ahead and use one. As we do pick one up from this guy.
You've got some skills.
Why, thank you.
You pulled me out of the jaws of death. I owe you.
No problem, Lyle.
But we're not in the clear yet.
No?
I'm worried about the guards at the gate on the top floor of this tower.
Hmm.
It's safe to say Mito will attack them, just like he attacked us. That gate is the only way to get to the provisional government, after all. We can't let Mito get any closer to Silva.
See, Lyle remembers the Cerberus troops, since he is one. He remembers them being the guards at the top of the tower. He remembers them being regular Cerberus troops. But when you get up there, as most everyone knows, the Cerberus troops are not up there. So here's a missile. Instead, it is the Blade Baron Cannoneer. And this is a shortcut run back back to the beginning of the level. So we find out later on in Valerio's vestiges and memories that there were two Cerberus troops in the memories, and one is carrying the Burning Disaster, and one is carrying this sword right here, the Ice Blood. And it is indeed the two Cerberus troops, and it's kind of interesting that Bandai included them in the game in this way, and their entire story is about how they transformed into the Lost under the leadership, I guess you could say, of Mito. So it's interesting that Lyle is still under the impression that they are still the Cerberus, part of his Cerberus troop up at the top of the tower, even though they are not. So, kind of interesting that he got left behind. The two Cerberus troops got turned at the top of the tower here with Mito's experiments, and that's how they come to be who they are. So there's the Silver Garb plus 8. It's a very, 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 very good fire resistance blood veil. Here you can see it's a 51 and a very good ice, and it's got really, really good defenses overall. So if you're looking for a very good blood veil overall, it's a really, really good veil for your first time through the game, but it is very, very, very heavy. Also, it's a stinger veil, so it affords you some distance if you need to. Have that distance, you can definitely go for it. Okay, so we're not getting too much benefit here out of opportunism, simply because everybody we backstab, we completely annihilate them very, very quickly and easily. And Night Fog Veil paired with Night Stalker allows us for exceptional sneak ability here. Okay, so 18,000 on this fella, I mean, that's just crazy. Okay, you can see there that it just takes three slashes and these guys go down. There's really no reason to take any kind of damage through here, except for, you know, making mistakes and such. So, as you see, we're at half health now, but that's from the invasion. From these guys, there should be no reason why Night Stalker shouldn't give us the upper hand in basically every encounter. So anytime you're going through the cathedral, or the, not the cathedral, this looks like a cathedral. Anytime you're going through the spire here, I would highly recommend playing a stealth. Excuse me. Oh, excuse me, let's drink some water. I would highly recommend going stealth through here with some kind of high backstab potential veil. I guess my voice is permanently changed forever. It's kind of weird. It's an exceptional way to go about getting to every area easily, quickly, and effectively. Okay, and let's go ahead and blend in with the scenery here. Okay, and we'll go for concentration. Now this fella, you can farm him for a Lost Y-Hander if you so choose, but this is very, very far out of the way. And there you go, we don't even have the chance to get one. There we go. Okay, there we go. Okay, and we got a couple more monkeys. Okay, and let's go for a drain while we have the time. I mean, why not? There we go. Okay, and Louis will finish him off. So there you see the stun ability and the cloaking ability absolutely helps us. And we get another missile root. So this is a very, very valuable item to come across here in Vayne. And if you're having a hard time, you know, missile rooting back and forth to different missiles to regen and recover at different times, I highly recommend coming in here and picking one up before you head on your adventures through the rest of the playthroughs. Okay, and we got more warrior things, and we got more Hephaestus things to pick up here in the Crypt Spire, as we can go back to home base now and pick up Rin's blood code, Hephaestus, and that's a very, very good blood code. Has a lot of really valuable things in it. Let's take a look here. Where is it? There you go. You can see that we have Dancing Blaze, Swift Destruction, Avarice, Pioneer's Guidance, and Countermeasure. Those are the ones I think that would be the most beneficial. I mean, it's basically the entire, blood code is very, very valuable. Okay, so now in here you can actually sneak in, no problem, before you even actually do anything. But we're gonna sneak, permanent sneak. So if you just go around the side here, they won't detect you, and you can go ahead and get in before anything happens. And if you take out the two side guys first, the fella in the middle won't activate until they are both dead. Okay? But since we are having Night Stalker, he doesn't activate at all. But there you go. And that's these three fellas. So these guys can go very quickly, very easily. We're getting a lot of titanium, I see. That's very nice. So if you're looking for a really fun, exciting way to kind of sneak your way through and again play Code Vein in a very, very, very different way, as every enemy in here can definitely one-shot you, this is a great way to keep yourself going and keep yourself alive no matter what. Oops, we're stuck there. Okay, let's go down this elevator. So this is how you pick up the rest of the missiles in this in the spire here, and some of Rin's pieces of her blood code. So here's this ladder to go down there, and you can see the drop downs continue to go through the ceiling. So this kind of looks like the Tower of Trials a little bit. So here's this missile, and then over here is there we go, Hephaestus B. And there's some, you know, just more things here to break, just for fun. So that's this area. So you want to come in here to get Rin's blood code and finish up the missiles that are here in the spire. Okay. And as you see, there's really no danger to us if we continue to run an invisibility kind of a play. We definitely can hold our own no matter what. So let's go ahead and blend in, get gift extension going so it lasts longer, because in this area you have these two in one room in a very, very small quarters, and it is exceptionally dangerous. So we will just go ahead and beat this fella down quickly, and we'll go for a backstab on this guy if we can get it. There we go. Now this guy doesn't pose a threat on his own. He only poses a threat when the Dark Hunter, when the Gilded, the Black Hunter is here, as the Black Hunter will aggro you before this fella does over here that we attacked. But then as soon as you're aggroed with the Black Hunter, this fella will stand up and he will stagger his attack pattern into you in such a way that every time the Black Hunter is missing you, then he will be striking you. So it can be very, 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 very problematic going in there, and I highly recommend going for the Black Hunter first, as he will allow you to get through there no problem. Okay, we'll go for a couple backstabs here and get some I-Cor here so we can go up and beat up the chunky fella. Now this is important to show that, you know, for the 100% here, we did that Black Hunter, we went up the little ramp there, and what did we get for it? We got a piece of titanium, which at this point in the game is completely, like, it's useful and everything, but it's not as useful as it could be, simply because of the fact that we are getting so much damage out on the enemy anyways. We're not really collecting too much. Okay, so here's the key, and here's an interesting little artifact that if you dash forward, you can't go down. You can't you can't dash at all over the edge, but if you just walk off, you fall down. So kind of strange there, but you know, that's what it is. So anytime you find these little buggy type of things, they actually are pretty funny, but it can help keep you on the map rather than falling down. So that's very nice. And here again, we run around the outside. Anytime you are in these areas, if you run around the outside, it will be much, much better for you, as opposed to going straight down the middle. So never approach these rooms from the center. And we'll go for Night Stalker. Okay. And maybe get a backstab here. Nope. No backstab. Okay. Okay. And he almost got stunned, but not quite. Okay, so we'll go for concentration, and we'll go for stun, and we will go for both camouflage and a sound suppressor, as we have our favorite friends dropping in here, and we don't want them to see us, and we want to lower that ladder. Now you sometimes get two monkeys, or sometimes you get one monkey. There we go. Oops, monkey sees us, so let's slash him down. So you can see there that our weapon strikes do very, very well against the monkeys when we're paired up with stun, as we can stagger them and put them into a stun state in only two strikes. Now here's our second lottery ticket for the Lost Y-Hander. Let's see if we get it. I highly doubt it, but you never know. You never know. Okay. So we had two chances this time, and both came up short. So that's unfortunate, but that's what it is. And now that we know the one shot on Mito, we can go ahead and do that with him, as that is a fantastic way to get around his stupidity. Okay, so then over here we have more boxes to break before we head on up. And you hear somebody talking. So here's Hephaestus A. Okay, so we've got Warrior and Hephaestus, Blood Code and Vestiges in here. Okay, and there's nothing. Oh, there's a tacos. These are kind of hidden, but you know, they're there if you want to pick them up.
Yes, it's
okay. And up we go. So now we can switch on over to our special ability here to try this out and see if we can go for the one shot here on the twofer. So we'll see if we can actually get it this way, and if not, then we will try a different variant of the two for one shot. Now this will most likely be used on normal game. If you are level 300, you have all the gifts, and you're ready to go, and you've got everything listed up here and everything, then you can definitely most likely do both of them in one shot. But here on the hardest difficulty, we're gonna see what we can do, and we're gonna missile route out directly, and we'll go ahead and watch the cutscene here and see them come to life and see them as Mito's puppets. Now remember, these were two Cerberus soldiers that Mito turned into these fine specimens here. Okay. Dun dun dun. Let's drink some water while Yakumo's yelling.
You know I'd love to stay and greet you properly.
But
I'm afraid I'm on a tight schedule.
He's got a date with a dude. See, I knew Mito was different.
What the? And how were they? The humble hors d'oeuvres that I so generously prepared for you.
Lost here. They were your experiments?
You're insane.
Jack's burn.
Of course, has just arrived.
So out of all of Jack's everything, this is the one time where his comment is actually kind of a lame burn. It's like, you're insane. It sounds so juvenile. It's pretty hilarious. But other than that, Jack is one of the best characters in the game. And he has one of the best parts. He has one of the best story arcs and character arcs and everything. He's a really good character. They did a really good job with Jack. Okay, and we're going to simply missile out here so we can get set up. Anytime you enter the fight the first time, it doesn't really go too well. Okay, and it puts you directly in front of both of them, which is not what we want to be. We want to have them at a distance and have the blade bearer charge us, and we want the cannoneer to stay back. Let's see, we don't need any of this anymore, so we will need this, and we will need I guess we'll go for this. There's really nothing else that we need here. Okay, so we'll see if we can go for the twofer here. Now, this particular setup here, solo, when I'm at the dummy back at home base, this particular setup here goes for 95,212 damage, without Jack, obviously, because you don't have Jack at the dummy, so Jack doubles that. So you can get upwards of 190,000 damage if... while not accounting for enemy defenses, but also if you do the variant where you go for Blow of Madness. Now this variant here goes for 98,842 solo, so paired up with Jack you can damage cap double basically, but if you go for Survival Instinct, Merciless Reaper, and you change Adrenaline here for Blow of Madness, and you run this setup here directly, this runs for 93,603. So this is the lowest amount of damage possible, or the lowest damage combination that you can go for. So we are going to go for the highest damage, the second highest damage value here, but we're going to see what Merciless Reaper does to ignore Chunky Boy's defenses here, because he's stronger to pierce than he is to crush. He's weak to ice crush, but since we're going to be doing piercing damage, the blade bearer will evaporate instantaneously, and the big healthy boy, he will be left over with some amount of health. So I guess we can go for Ichor Concentrate here, since we're going to need some more shots out of our bayonet to shoot this guy. We'll see what we can get here, if we can get both in one shot. Okay, here we go. Let's get it going. Okay, and Merciless Reaper, this. Yep, okay. And one more. We'll do Final Journey. We'll do this. Ranged Impact, this. We'll go ahead and heal one. And we'll do this, and we'll go for Jack. Okay. Now, since life doesn't matter at this point, since we don't have Survival Instinct, it's simply a matter of just getting enough health here to, get our gifts going. Okay, we'll go for this, and we'll go for this, and we'll get Ichor Concentrates on deck. Okay, now we gotta target him and let her charge us. Okay. Where is she? We are not set up. Okay. So Ranged Impact ran out, so we need to do that closer to the end. So we will see here if we can actually get them lined up, as Jack will aggro a little bit here, and that's kind of a problem. So we'll have to... We want her to go after us, but then back up, so that way... And we have to be targeting the cannoneer at all times. Okay, let's try this again. There we go. There we go. And we need to time our shot, but not to the point that we okay, we will heal. But not to the point that we do an accident and miss, we have to be really, really careful with how we go about this. Okay, there we go, and we'll heal with Final Journey. Okay, we'll do this. Two, and then one more. There we go, and we'll get Radiant Barrel going. Now, again, lining this up is very, very tricky, but we definitely have the power to do it, so let's aggro him, and let's get her going. Okay, and right there. Oh, we missed her somehow. Okay. I don't know how we missed her, but the Cannoneer almost went down. So that makes me think that maybe ignoring his defenses is not as important as putting out the highest damage potential possible. So we will switch to Blow of Madness. So that's kind of what I wanted to see there, was what it would do versus him. So it did not kill him, but it definitely put him very, very close. So we will see here. We will see here if we can get it again. Okay, so here we go. So this is kind of a fun challenge to see if you can actually get the twofer on the highest difficulty. I've not seen anybody do it, so this will be kind of fun if we can. Okay, and we'll go for this, and we'll go for Jack. Now, after we use Jack's communal, we can't heal with regeneration, so we have to kind of use that sparingly here. Okay, there we go. And we'll go for this, and this, and a gift accelerator. Okay, and we'll do this. There we go. Okay, and let's go. Now, hopefully the extra damage increase there will be enough to put her down. There we go. Ah, I missed her again. What? How did I miss her? She must be... She must be just to the side there, but you can see that Merciless Reaper definitely is more useful than Blow of Madness, even though it gives us about 3,600 more damage. The ignoring his a little bit of his armor is worth way more than adding more damage. Okay, so let's go ahead and pick up our Haze here, as I don't want to lose the 50 million just because I don't want to. Okay, so I gotta get a better setup here to dodge over to her, and then as soon as she starts moving, because as you can see, she's still in the damage reduction phase, it looks like, and immediately after that, she stops the damage reduction phase, it looks like, so we will have to somehow get her to come over to us. And line up. Okay. So instead of making the fight hard based on, actually fighting them, we can make the fight hard by simply having the requirement to shoot both of them in one shot. But I don't think we can actually get there, simply because Big Boy takes enough damage that we can't put him down in one shot. Okay, there we go, and we'll go over to this. There we go. And Radiant Barrel, okay, there we go. Menuing is hard, okay, and let's go. Now, aggro him, or lock onto him, get her to come over here, and, okay. Now we need to, line up, okay. Jack, thanks, okay. Okay, almost got him. Getting her to line up is very, very problematic, but I think I did enjoy going through the Crypt Spire here with the sneaky Hades build, as Hades is not usually looked at as an assassin kind of a build or a blood coat, but it can definitely be used that way with the Twilight Claw, and we'll see if we can get this. Get this one shot here, or at least very, very close, because it'll be a one shot, use an Ike or concentrate, and then shoot the Big Boy again. There we go. And do the heal two times. Come on, there we go. Okay, and Jack. So it is a lot of fun to put artificial requirements on different builds and different challenges throughout the game here, I think, anyways. It's not everyone's cup of tea. But I definitely think it's a lot of fun to see if you can try for these different kind of challenge run things. Okay, let's go. Okay, she's gonna go for us. Yes! Oh, and Jack got us back. Okay, let's go ahead and get an Iker concentrate, and then we'll shoot him once. There we go. Okay, so it does work. It's just a little goofy there. Okay, so now we head on up to the Mito fight. So when they line up like that, you can absolutely slaughter them. But this build right here, if you pair this up on normal game or normal mode, and you go for this kind of setup here, you can absolutely one-shot them, no problem. But we got really, really close on the hardest difficulty, so I'm pretty proud of that. I'm pretty happy with that. Okay, so now we find out a little bit more about Mito's plans here.
Stop right there, Mito.
Your persistence is tiring.
So tell me, just what exactly are you after anyway? What do you have to gain in reviving the Queen?
Reviving the Queen?
Evil bad guy laugh. Excellent.
So damn funny.
I've collected enough data already. I have no more use for the Queen.
Then why?
Let me ask you something. Do you ever sit back and wonder why you were created in the first place?
Ooh, good question. Even a better question. Oh, 18-year-olds.
Aren't you forgetting something? The day of the great collapse. The creatures that caused all that ruin.
I was young and dumb once.
Both Revenants and the Queen were created to eliminate those horrors. And yet, they are all still incomplete. Gregorio's monstrous transformation with my own eyes, but sadly it cannot be. Now, allow me to show you the truth of our world.
Ooh. Here we go. So now these are more relics that have. So these are other parts of the Queen, and they are here that Mito has been doing experiments with them. So I guess I shouldn't say that. You know, I was young and dumb once. 18-year-olds. You know, when you're that age, you're full of ideals. I guess is more what it should be. And you've got ideas, you know, based on things, and you know, it's not that they're wrong, it's just maybe they're misguided or not fully aware of everything. So I mean, I was an 18-year-old once, and I turned out okay. Most people are okay how they turn out. It's just sometimes, you know, that's the rebellious stage in life, sometimes it's the self-discovery stage in life, sometimes it's, you know, a new chapter in life, and sometimes it can be a little confusing, and that's why I think, you know, that saying of young and dumb, I think that's where it comes from, is just that idea that, you know, once you're young, and you haven't been fully exposed to too many things, you know, you can either be misguided, or, you know, things can happen outside of your control that... Sorry, Silva. That you know, you may have not accounted for, and it may change your outlook on things. So I don't know. And here he's transforming into something. So right there, you saw him frenzy. He could not withstand the power of the relics anymore. But since he does not have all the relics, he cannot transform directly into the Queen, so he frenzies into his own version of a successor. So this is Cruz's dad, as we found out, and as they both share, you know, the name Silva, Cruz Silva, Gregorio Silva, they are father and daughter, and knowing that, you know, puts a whole different spin onto, you know, how you see Cruz and how you see Gregorio. So these two ladies are here back at home base, and they're feeling the repercussions of the frenzy. And they also get a good vantage point here of what Silva's been doing. Gregorio, that is. Let's drink some water. And the red mist is gone. So Gregorio's been putting that up as a barrier, and everybody thinks it's a horrible thing. But in fact, it actually turns out to be a very, 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 very good thing. Okay. Dun, dun, dun. So now that he's frenzying, the red mist is gone. Something sinister. Is prowling.
Red mist is fading.
Mm-hmm. Sure is.
Out. We can leave.
Do you want to leave? I mean, honestly. Do you want to clap your hands?
We're free. We can finally escape this horrible prison.
Oh, buddy. Oh, buddy. See, and the Cerberus troops are not bad.
We've been here so long.
They're just, once they turn into Lost, you know. Yeah, buddy. Ooh. No wonder they called them horrors. That is a dead Cerberus troop right there. And that big boy, from what I've read and been told, that is an Aragami.
Someone help! Please help me!
And Silva regains control, and the red mist comes back.
Still alive?
Yeah, you're still alive, and you're either in vein or you're out of vein. So, you better hope you're in vein. Okay, Mito's still unwinding his evil plan here. Mm-hmm. Dun dun dun. Maybe you won't. Mm-hmm.
They will be the source of even greater strength for all remnants. Evolution is everything. It is our duty, our very hope as a species.
Well, I mean,
Gregorio didn't
probably.
See that.
Yeah, but he did it for the good of saving Karen.
Eliminating the feeble horrors within his pen, and thus foolishly halted the march of progress.
See, Mito is anti-Karen.
But the horrors outside continued to evolve, until finally they transcended Revenants and became an existential threat.
However, I'm pro-Karen.
You fools noticed nothing. Our prison of red mist became a barricade, protecting Revenants from the horrors that awaited mm-hmm. them beyond its borders. All this time you were being shielded by Gregorio from reaching your true potential. The hypocrisy turns my stomach.
Yeah, but that comes at a price, doesn't it? So, is it really true potential? Well, I guess.
Bastard. After all you've done, just how many more lives are you willing to sacrifice?
Enough, Mito. We won't let you do this.
A pity. Those who are too weak to keep up with the speed of progress do not deserve to live. balance, Swill. We will stop you. After all they've done for everyone. The successors will not have suffered in vain.
Ooh, Red Rocket. How nice. So they talk about other successors suffering, but they should realize by now, I mean, we've saved all four of them, and, they should realize that, we save them. So I'm not exactly quite sure. So before we do Mito, we have one other place to head on to, as we currently are in this phase of the game. So we have to head back to the Crypt of the Ribcage after defeating these two successors. We did the Claw and we did the Throat, and we did not go back after the Claw to Karen's crypt here to pick up a pureblood, so I guess that negates the 100% run. if we go back to the crypt now, you will notice something a little different than what we had here before. Okay, and we will switch to our Mito kill here. Okay, and we need to change this to this. This is fine. Or no, that one's not fine. And we need Dex and Mind, and we need Strength and Dex. Okay, and then this will be Blood Sacrifice. This will switch to this, and this will switch to the Hounds. And this is... excuse me. And again, this is the definitive one-shot here on Mito, and this will be the option here that we will go for. And so now if we come back downstairs after we've finished the successor fights, and you roll back and forth, you can come back down here and I think we have to finish the Mito fight first. Okay. Once we're done with Mito, we can come back here, and we will be greeted with a very special gift. Okay, so apologies for that. I thought it was I thought we could come back here now, but it doesn't look like it's the case. Upper level, there we go. So it's fun to definitely do the one shots when possible. If you're not doing one shots and you're actually doing an actual fight, Mito can be very, very, very problematic, as he's weak to only crush. All other elements and status effects and everything else will be reduced or negated completely. And so it's very, very important to kill him quickly and effectively. Otherwise, he will completely ruin your day. Alright, so as we head on up here, now again, the reason that this is more damage than anything else is because of the multiplicative effects for the Wrathful Balmung, and there's no other weapon in the game that can actually get as high as the Wrathful Balmung for crush damage, so it's a little sad that you don't have access to this one shot unless you have the first DLC, which I think most people would by this point in time, but you never know. Okay, so let's go ahead and get our things going. And since we know this kill with confidence here, we can simply run in and just smash him and completely ruin him. Okay, and one more. There we go. We'll get Jack. Okay. Okay, let's go ahead and get our items going. Oh, and we need one more item. I forgot. Okay, and we need this, and we need this guy, and we need this, and let's go. There we go. And as soon as he comes out of his damage reduction phase, oh, good grief. Okay. So I need to missile back. As you can see, his damage reduction there, typically in the damage reduction phases, they are at a 90% damage reduction. So there you saw that we did about 24,000 or so. So if that was 90% reduction of 24,000 about divided by 0.9, or sorry, 0.9 divided by 24,000. No, what the heck? So yeah, we should have been doing about 240,000 there on that strike, but instead we did 24,000. So yeah, you can see that we definitely have enough damage to put this boy down. It's just a matter of fact of getting out of that damage reduction phase. Okay, so up we go. And that's a good way also to see what your damage potential is if you hit them while they're in the damage reduction phase early on. You can see exactly how much damage you're doing as you know, each of those damage points don't show up beyond the 999, the 5-9 level there. So it's important to see kind of what your damage ceiling could be if you need to see beyond the damage cap. Okay, so here we go. Okay, now we got to, again, we have to wait for the damage reduction phase to end here. There we go. And now, there we go. And there's Mito, which is so much fun to just take him down and be done with it. Okay, so now we have, now we have more cutscenes here. Okay, let's drink some water while we watch him turn to stone and ash. Yay! Now watch this very closely. No vestige comes out of him. Mito was not a successor of the body parts of the Queen.
Judging by the state of the Red Mist, I guess that Silva is in a lull at the moment. Still, he has to be on the brink of frenzy.
Oh yeah.
That means it's only a matter of time. Is there a way we can prevent it?
Yes. Legs for days. Even though I'm the short one.
Are you sure? Physically, it is possible.
Mm-hmm.
You might be able to take on Silva's relic.
And all the other three that went into him.
It will mean taking on Silva's mission as well. And that will not be an easy burden to bear.
Our world cannot survive without the power of the Red Mist.
That's right.
And that means you would have to sit on that throne forever. Are you truly prepared to accept that fate?
Why, of course I am. We're 100%ing the game, so we won't even accept the fate anyways.
Remember, you're not alone.
Hello, Wings.
I may not be able to help you in any tangible way. But at the very least, I'm willing to accompany you on the journey.
That's a tangible way. Well, maybe not.
You got a big burden to carry there. I'm around to help lift it.
Yakumo and his friends.
We're friends. We'll fight together.
That's right. Okay. A nice touching end there to slaughtering three bosses in one go there. As they take a little bit of setup and a little bit of finesse to finagle your way into those one-shots, it definitely is exceptionally fun to be able to go ahead and damage them in that way. Okay, so now as we will be heading on into the government center here, and we will be picking up more depths maps, the Misty Ruins and the Rocky Ruins, and we will pick up with the other optional missions in the next one. So thank you all for watching, and we'll see you then.